Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. As usual, we start with the SGI graph of the previous time frame with magnitude 5.5 and larger earthquakes projected on this graph. And what we see is the large earthquakes, of course, the 7.4 that I discussed in the previous update right at the beginning, which was, of course, not triggered by the planetary conjunction that you see there, but by the lunar geometry that preceded that large earthquake. You may want to look up the previous update for that analysis. We see on 21st, 22nd of July, the geometry that I discussed, the convergence of geometry, that was with the full moon. And we see indeed an obvious clustering of strong earthquakes, magnitude 6 earthquakes, 3 of them in Guatemala and Vanuatu too. And also 5.7, 5.6 at Panama Costa Rica border region. So this is an obvious clustering that we see at the time of that convergence of critical planetary and lunar geometry. Then on the 25th and 26th, 24th, 25th, we had lunar peaks. This is because of lunar conjunctions with Saturn and Neptune. And I estimated that there could be some seismic, an obvious seismic response on the 26th, 27th as a result of that lunar geometry. But we did in fact have three stronger earthquakes, some clustering, minimal clustering on the 25th. It peaked 5.8 at the South Sandwich Islands region nonetheless. At the South Sandwich Islands region, we have roughly a strong to very major earthquake every 2 years on average. We haven't seen large earthquakes in that area, and that's because 3 years ago in August, we had a 7.5 and 8.0, a double major great earthquake at the South Sandwich Islands region, major rupture of that subduction zone. But we do see increased seismic activity, an obvious building up of stress in the area, so it may not be long before a larger earthquake is going to occur in that area again. Other than that, we didn't have stronger earthquakes in the previous time frame, not on the 26th, 7th or 28th, nothing 5.5 and larger. Before I go to the next time frame, people have asked me about the planetary and lunar geometry, the specific angles that we analyze, that we emphasize actually in the SGI models. This is in fact based on the properties of the electromagnetic wave. I'll keep it simple, but really quick. The electromagnetic wave has an electric field and a magnetic field, always. And they are always at a 90 degree angle, or in a 90 degree relationship. And the geometry that we emphasize, that is related to the 90 degree angle of the electromagnetic wave. So we look at 0 degrees, 45 degrees, 90 degrees, 135 degrees, and 180 degrees, which is basically 0 degrees. So that, in a nutshell, is why we emphasize that particular geometry. It is very much related to the electromagnetic wave. We also have documented this on our website. You may want to look that up. Okay, so now let's have a look at the next time frame. We only have one planetary conjunction, that will be Venus and with the Sun and Saturn, and that will be on the 30th. Other than that, we have no planetary conjunctions, but we do have some obvious critical planetary geometry and also lunar geometry, especially on the 29th and 30th. We have a convergence of critical planetary and lunar geometry, and we see that Venus is very much present there. These are the purple labels that you see in the solar system. We see that particular geometry, Venus, very prominent, and also the Moon, quite some lunar geometry, and that's because of the conjunctions with Uranus, Mars, and Jupiter. But we also have the situation that the Moon will be making right angle geometry with Saturn, Mercury, and Venus in a very short time. And I do expect an obvious seismic increase as a result of that lunar geometry. These are the green lines. And that is very significant. And this is all happening on the 29th and 30th of July. Expect an obvious seismic increase. This can be a cluster of stronger earthquakes, the typical cluster, magnitude 5.5 in larger earthquakes. There can also be a considerable six-pointer in there, and maybe even magnitude 7. We have also critical geometry coming up on the 2nd and 4th, later on the 2nd, early on the 4th of August, and that's the typical right angle geometry that I often emphasize between Mercury, Venus and Uranus, and that is something to keep an eye on because it can produce a mid-7 magnitude earthquake. It doesn't do that all the time, and the last time that this particular geometry occurred was in late March, and within 5 days we had the magnitude 7.4 earthquake in Taiwan. And you may want to look up the update of 25 March because in there I do an in-depth analysis of that geometry and also what that geometry did in 2023. Because there is an almost one-to-one relationship between that geometry and those large earthquakes. We have that geometry again on the 2nd and the 4th of August. Again, there can be a large earthquake, but it doesn't do that all the time. It depends on the stress levels in Earth's crust. And to be honest, I do not know which of the geometry is going to trigger the larger earthquake. Will it be on the following the geometry on the 29th and 30th of July, or will it be following the geometry on the 2nd, 4th of August? I'm not sure, but in either case, I do expect an obvious seismic response. And in the solar system, we see that geometry on 2, 4 August. Again, Venus, prominent. The lunar geometry as well. This is very interesting lunar geometry, by the way, because we have semi-right angle geometry with outer planets. But the outer planets are on different positions, and that makes it more critical. So again, I do expect an obvious seismic increase. This could be mid to high 6 easily with that lunar geometry with Mars, Jupiter and Saturn, that semi-right angle geometry. And if the Moon makes that in a very short time, within hours or within 1 day, that is critical. And that's what we're going to have on the 29th, but more so on the 30th and the 31st of July, just preceding the critical geometry with Mercury, Venus and Uranus. So that's the geometry that we are going to have. We also have been working on the atmospheric fluctuations because we had some difficulty since May. Again, this may have been due to intense solar activity. We still have intense solar activity because on the 23rd of July there was an X14, CME that's really big. Fortunately, it wasn't Earth-facing, it was on the other side, but it's really, really big. And the Sun has been very, very active this year so far. Now, the atmospheric fluctuations that we've been recording in the last couple of days, that was over Africa and marking the Mediterranean as well. We had 4.5 the other day in the central Mediterranean. These atmospheric fluctuations, they do not always indicate a large or strong seismic activity. It can also be a moderate seismic event in an area where that kind of seismic activity does not occur very often. And we had one the other day off the coast of Libya or Tunisia, I think it was. And south of Africa as well. And we see that on the 24th, we had these atmospheric fluctuations over Africa and Western Africa towards the Atlantic. We had fluctuations marking Guerrero, Mexico, and the eastern part, southeast part towards or close to South America. And we had on the 27th, just recently, atmospheric fluctuations over the Atlantic. So again, there may be stronger seismic activity coming up near the South Sandwich Islands region. But in general, the Atlantic, there we may see some seismic increase there. Check out the website for the latest updates and also the atmospheric fluctuations. We also share them in the social media. This is the update for now. Stay safe. Until next time.